My dear friend of the faction and, of course, citizens of Israel, I just came from Shimon Peres' memorial. May his memory be blessed. I knew Shimon personally, and I saw in him a man of vision that always wanted what was the good for his people and the future generations was always important to him. It's the time has come that we should do the same, put the benefit of our people before any other interest. After this elections that was cast upon us, and the citizens went and voted, and it was a clear decision. They want unity. The people have asked that Israel should come first, and therefore blue and white, with me at the head, have won the elections, and they are the biggest party. Based on the election committee, we have got 33, and Benjamin Netanyahu did not achieve that bloc that he hoped to achieve, that actually dragged all of us into elections. Friends, citizens of Israel wanted a unity even immediately after the previous elections. They want one today, a unity government. And I'd like to remind you all that I've been talking about that for over a whole year. I intend to do so, a broad one, a liberal one, headed by myself, a government that will bring the wishes of the people and our basic promises to the public for the people. We'll bring about a whole change in priorities, and we will cure Israeli society with all its parts. The starting of the formation of the government has started. We will not surrender to any dictates. We will listen carefully to everyone, but we will not surrender to any dictate. The negotiations will be directed by myself and done with deep considerations in order to exhaust all the possibilities and the potential for the citizens of Israel in the political circumstances created. This negotiation will need us to be long-winded, but to keep to our principles. There will be no shortcuts. The government formed by me must be effective and be able to execute issues and have true governance. Any other thing will not be for the sake of Israel. Dear citizens, in order to create a unity government, you don't come with political blocks and spins, but you come with statesmanship, with sincerity and honesty. I intend to act in that way, in that spirit. I said so beforehand, and I will go in the spirit of that little note I left in the Wailing Wall the evening before the elections. May we all be blessed, and peace will be upon us.